As an elderly woman was lying on her deathbed, she had the task of finalizing the division of her estate among her three daughters. The youngest daughter was kind, soft-hearted, and selfless. She cared for and lived with her mother since she became immobile 17 years ago. This daughter gave up her youth to look after her dear mother. She didn't study further, and she didn't get married. She stood by her mother, loved her, washed her, fed her, and spent every cent she had on ensuring a good quality life for her. The second daughter got caught up in the busyness of her own life and family. The visits to her mother became shorter and scarcer, until eventually they subsided. The third daughter was a troublemaker, a reckless spender, and regularly abused alcohol. The old woman didn't have to think twice before deciding to give each daughter an equal share. When a relative saw this, he said, "How can you give them all an equal share? Surely the first one is more deserving. She's been caring for you all of these years. You must be senseless." The old lady replied, "When I distribute my estate to my three children, it is an expression of what I feel. They are my children, my blood. I love them all equally and unconditionally. A third, a third, a third, it shall be." This old lady knew something most of us ought to know, something that will most certainly make the world a better place if believed and lived out by all. She knew that true love is unconditional. It doesn't become less, and it is not dependent on anything. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. During my time as Miss World, I had the privilege to visit many countries around the globe. If you're unfamiliar with beauty pageants, the Miss World organization's mantra is beauty with a purpose. The purpose and sole focus is creating meaningful change in the lives of the less fortunate. When I traveled to different countries, I didn't just attend events in capital cities and tourist attractions with the rich and famous. I had the opportunity to visit the places that most tourists may never even hear of. The places and communities where the less privileged dwell and survive. The communities that some tourists may not even want to know of. The orphans and the poor, the sick and the weak. But visiting these places, that was where I found my true calling. I still remember this particular moment during one of my most memorable trips like it was yesterday. It was a hot summer's day in Mexico, and we visited an orphanage in a very destitute and remote area. A young orphan girl came to me. She was around 5 years old with olive skin and the most beautiful big brown eyes. At first she was very shy, but she moved closer and closer until she was standing with her mouth right next to my ear, where I was kneeling down to be closer to the children, when she asked me a question that I will remember for the rest of my life. A question that was translated to me and sparked a realization within me. She asked whether I was a real-life princess and if I would take her home with me to my castle. In that moment, two souls communicated. That one sentence struck me in the heart. Here I was, privileged to be in the position that I was, contrasted by this girl who had nothing, absolutely nothing on earth, but she had hope. In that moment, I realized that I was wrong to think that it would require multiple lifespans to be able to make a tangible difference in the world around me. With the right focus, I would be able to make a concrete difference during my lifetime. While I may not be wealthy in monetary terms, I realized that I was blessed with a platform that enables me to be a human catalyst for positive change in the world. I realized that it is not my right to deny the blessings that were given to us. You, listening right now, you are more privileged than someone, somewhere. And just like we should not deny the blessings that we are given, it is not our right to deny the blessing that we can give to others. We have the power to lift them high and enable them to bless others. One individual at a time. One gesture at a time. One act of love at a time. Unconditionally.